I don't know how many of you know her personally, but she lives in Kolkata. She lives in a joint family, has a five-year-old son. She is a graduate in English literature, and now she is pursuing master's in environmental studies. This master's she started because she joined a course by BNHS called as Basic Course in Ornithology. After that, she wanted to learn more about nature, conservation process, climate change, biodiversity mapping, etc. So that's her passion. She is running her own company with her husband and a few team members that is into web designing and social media marketing. She is the founder of that company, W3 Web Help. She's been doing it for the last 10 years. She's also done an animation course a long time back. She is very much interested in wildlife photography, bird watching, bird count sensors, painting, gardening, and books. She says that traveling is her oxygen, and she usually travels once or twice in a month. But now, because of the lockdown, she's like a fish out of the water, and she's also a painter. As you know, that she is in the web designing background, so no person better than her to talk about blogging and how we can get into this particular area. With any subject you do, you will need this particular expertise. So over to you, Anrila. Before that, final request. Everybody, please mute your devices. Otherwise, I will mute you. Put your videos off. Otherwise, I will put them off. There is a chat window also in this application. You can put things in your chat. If you are, we will be having a few sections in this particular meeting. So we will be taking questions after each section, and you can put them on chat. And then I will read out, and Andrila will answer those questions. So thank you very much for your patience. Over to you, Andrew.
Hello, hello. I'm audible to you.
Yes, very much audible and visible. Thank you.
Okay. Hi everyone. Today my subject is how to write blog and present it and host it. So I need to share my screen. I will try to. I know it's Sunday and a very boring subject, but still I'll try to make it interesting so that you can restrict yourself from having a quick sleep during the session. Okay, so I think the PPT, you can see my PPT, right?
Yes, Anila, we can see. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. So who should start their blog and why? Every one of you who joined in this session, he or she must want to have some blog. That's why they got interested in this topic and came here. So who should start? If you have a writing tendency, most of you I know virtually or personally have joined. I can see them joining here. So some of you have some text that you have already written as travelog, or any birding experience like that you want to share. So most of you only share your photos and travelog in Facebook, but Facebook really don't have any archive value. You should arrange everything systematically, methodically in a blog, as per I think, because there you can find anything very easily, and you can share the link also with your friends so that they can take quick reference. For example, if you are a barter, if you are a traveler, then you can, you may have some observation details, you may have some travelogue written. So if you are sharing it in Facebook, people will, you already, you know that if we put any kind of photo or travelogue in Facebook, the lifespan of this is only 2-3 days. After 2-3 days, you will not get any like from that particular post, because Facebook is like, it's ever emerging. I mean, your post will be, it's like a, it will go down and the new post will come up. So your post will not get any like or anything, because the lifespan of the blog is only 2-3 days. So what will be after that? You will forget, and your friends will forget, and only Facebook memory can remember, which is automatic process, and you will get notified after 1 year that last year you have visited that that particular place, or last year you have seen this bird. So you actually, you have forgot, you there would be a tendency that you might not remember that one also. I mean, it's not that people will forget, you will forget also, I think. So you want to, I think blog is only for you, because there you can arrange everything, and this is perfect for you. Okay, now how to start your first blog? Many of you don't know where to start and how to do. I will show you the free options here only. How to start, there are three options. I mean, there are many options, but these are popular, most popular: Blogger, WordPress, and Wix. So basically, another thing is, what is the difference between a website and a blog? Blog needs to be updated regularly, and blogs are, company blogs are also there, but when we are talking about blog in this particular session, most of you are not from any representative of any company. You are you came here only to learn about personal blog. So personal blog, you can create personal blog from blogger.com, from wordpress.com, and from wix.com. okay, so why I have put a baby picture behind, because your blog is like your own child. I mean, it's like a newborn baby. You have to nurture it, and you cannot expect anything from it, that it will boom like a bomb, and everyone will like you. And I will also tell you about the monetization of it. And it's not that very easy to get, you know, monetized your blog and to popularize it, because in Facebook I have seen that if you will share, if you write in Facebook text, people have you know, there is a tendency that people will read it, and if you post the video there, people will view it. And if you put a YouTube link there, or if you put a blog link there, which will redirect the your friends to the particular site, particular your blog or anything, they have not that, they are not very usual to do this. Because if you have a good piece of, you can paste it today. If you have a good piece of writing, you can put in Facebook like you did, or a photograph. So if you put in Facebook, people will like it more. But if you put it in anywhere else, so I mean your blog or your YouTube channel, people will not, most of the people will not visit, but gradually they will be, I mean, getting interest, and they will come, I think. Okay, the next phase I will show, it's not, I mean, Blogger, WordPress, and Wix. I will gradually show these three options, how to make blog with blogger.com, with wordpress.com, and with wix.com. Okay. So this is my, this is blogger.com. You need to type in the browser, blogger, blogger.com, and then you need to sign in. they will ask your Gmail account. I have already logged in with my Gmail account. So blogger.com is actually from Google, so it is easier. Now you will be seen as blogger profile. So for example, my display name would be taste. Continue to blogger. So your profile is created. Now there is an option just below the logo of the blogger. It is create blog. Now I have to give the title. For example, if you are, your name is XYZ ABC. XYZ is your name and ABC would be your surname. So the title would be like XYZ ABC. Or if you want it to be like, for example, I am running a birding blog. So my name is Oindrila, but my birding blog, that is my name, I have put it in a branding. Its name is Wild India Travels. So you can create both. You can create it with your name or a branding, anything you want. Okay. So let me give you a title like it. Blog one, it could be my title, and address is when it is a free blog, so the blogger URL will also come with your blog name. Like okay, I will change the title, changing its tasting, and the address will be here comes the auto suggestion, that tasting.blogspot.com. You cannot remove the blogspot.com in free option, but if you are going to take the paid version, then you will get a custom URL. Okay. So it is not available. Okay, I make it tasting123. Tasting123 is also not available. All address are taken. I'm putting in a gibberish name and it is available. Okay. Now I have to click the create blog option. Another one is cancel. So I think you will not click it. Okay, now your blog is created. Okay, so you have to post it. Another thing is layout. You can see there are many options from the left panel of your blog. From layout, you can see these options. I mean, sidebar, gadget, etc. You need to drag and drop it. And there is also a theme. You can choose any theme. There are many themes available. For example, I'm choosing this one. There are many themes available, you can see. If you are creating a blog, everything will be visible to you. And you can preview this, so it will be your a preview. So I'm just apply this. Okay, new theme is applied. So now main thing is blog posting, which we are familiar about. That I have, for example, I have visited a place, or I have to write any burning experience. So these will be my post. So the post page is the post option is the top most of the left panel, and we have to click there, and then the create new post option from the bottom right. It's a plus sign. I have to give the title. Title should be Test Birding. And here is the text, body text. Put anything, your travelogue, your birding experience, your observation details, anything in body text. Even you can write in Bengali also if you are habituated. And also the Wix, WordPress, and and Blogger, they have a mobile application also. So you need to set up the site from the computer, and then for the regular update, you can do it from your mobile also. That is actually working from mobile is more user-friendly for most of the people. That's why I'm sharing this. Now you have to, this is your body text and this is your title. Now you have to click the insert image, and it will be uploading. There are many options, like by URL, you can fetch it from the external URL or any blogger profile or the photos of all. I'm clicking the upload prop. Load from the computer. So your photo comes here, and the body text is there, and Test Birding, this is the title. Now you can put the label also. Labeling means will it be a birding trip, or you can label it like Himalayan birding, like anything else, like okay, anything. I mean, labeling is like categorizing for your future reference. Okay. And then you have to, this is the publish option. Okay. Publish post, and this this will publish this post to your blog. Confirm. Okay, now your it is not showing, maybe due to the file size. Another thing is, when you are uploading your media into your blog, you need to reduce the size. One minute. Let me do it with another image.
Mandrila, while you are attaching the image, quick question. Mm-hmm. What is the difference between the blog and the post? You can tell us.
No, blog is actually the whole thing. And post, I mean, this is actually a whole thing, your blog. But blog post is different. I mean, the post is when you are telling that I'm writing a blog, it means you are writing a post actually.
Okay, so does it mean that a blog has got different subjects? So I can have a blog for birds, I can have a blog for education, I can have a blog for something else.
Yes.
And whenever I go on birding trips, I can add a post.
Yes. Actually, blog is the overall thing. It's your website, actually. That's why I have told that what is the difference between a blog and a website? That website need not to update regularly, but blog usually people do. Like, it's your diary. When you are maintaining a diary, you need not to, diaries are expected to update every day, but people usually, sometimes they don't get the time or anything. Okay, another photo, test two. This will publish, okay, confirm. Post is published. Okay. So this is my post. Actually, this is the test one. Okay. This is the latest post. And I think it is clear enough. Now you can ask me about changing these pictures and this. This you can change from the theme option. When you are choosing a theme, there is an option to customize. Okay, so you can customize this, and I will take a question answer after this blogger option is done. So I think question answer part will be now. We can take question answer if any one of you have any question about blogger, so you can ask me.
If you can type the questions, if you don't have a mic, otherwise you can unmute yourself and ask the question as well. There was a question earlier, do you have to type HTTPS when you are creating the blog post address?
No, nothing. When you are creating a blog post, this is as simple as I have shown. There was a plus sign and you will have to click there. And after you are opening your page, it is a blank page like your Microsoft Word. Then you have to just write your travelogue or write your experience and then the images gradually.
Another question is the option. Another question from Pampa. Can I create my own theme?
No, actually there are only something available here. So you have to,
Let me just stop sharing.
Yes, now it's okay. I clicked here. Okay. Choosing your theme. When I'm choosing my theme, there are some themes available here. Okay, so you only can customize this. Customizing means, for example, this one where I have put my mouse. The name is dark. You can change the image of the header. You can change these options, but the theme will be like that. Now you can drag and drop something from this layout option. For example, you can add a gadget. There are AdSense, featured post, blog search, and there are many gadgets available. gadgets means when we are watching a blog or a website, there are many options available and displayed everywhere. There are some blog posts and image, etc., etc. These are the sections or the gadgets. Those gadgets you can drag and drop in your website or in your blog, whatever, and you can update it. So after customizing a theme, if you are customizing a theme, so you can make it as good as possible. I mean, maybe the it will be like 80% different from the available theme here. I mean, you are choosing, for example, you are choosing this kind of simple theme. Now you have to dressing it up with extra things like AdSense and all these things, AdSense and gadgets like, you know, about me section, about me blog archive label and report abuse. These are available. So, I mean, these are already available in your chosen theme. You can add more gadgets. You can add AdSense, featured post, blog search, followers, image, Excel level, everything you can put, and your website or your blog will look different from the available theme. So I think yes, you can. You cannot create your own theme, like, but yes, you can. You can make it as good as possible and like you want. I mean, you don't need to create it, but you can make it the available theme. You have to choose any available theme and you can dressing it up according to your need. Anything else?
Yeah, there are many questions I'm coming to one by one, but just to tell you that it is 2:31 left, 31 seconds left. We will stop at when it says less than 1 minute. Okay. Till then, you can answer one question. The rest of the questions we'll take when we join back. How to make my blog popular?
Yes, I will answer it later. I mean, these are the different slides. First, I need to I can memorize it.
No problem. I'll ask that question later on. Won't the quality, Pratik is asking, won't the quality of images be hampered if we reduce the size for uploading?
No, I will give you some URL also through which you can just optimize it, because these images will be uploaded in your Google. I mean, a blogger is actually linked with Google. So if you are uploading 8-9 MB images for every image post, then your Google Drive will also, I mean, the available space, free space, that is, I think, 15 GB, that will reduce. So I think...
We can discuss that later. Okay. We will need to disconnect.
Okay. Okay. Any question I need to answer?
Yes, there are questions. Yeah, I will ask those questions. Okay, I will start with you mentioned about image quality. We will talk about it later on, you said.
Regarding image quality, I will show you how to popularize the blog. I have told that I will discuss this later. There are many actually options, but I personally use this tinypng.com. Here we can upload 20 images at a time, and the file size will reduce, but not the quality. So you can write it anywhere, or I will share it. Chat section.
Yeah, you will please note that you will need to take notes because there are no presentations or anything like that. So please take notes when you are here. Something.
Okay.
So Anila, you mentioned about tiny PNG. So I have to upload and then it becomes tiny and then I can download that. Is that how it is or keep it there?
No. You need to download it. They will give you a zip file. And your 8 MB, 10 MB size PNG, image, they will reduce in a few more KB only. So it will actually save your Google Drive, and also we need to optimize our blog. This is why I will let you know later. But you have to make it everything, less heavy. Less heavy with image and less heavy with tagging and labeling, which I was just mentioning when I'm showing the design, I'm showing the blogger profile. There are some level. You need not to, level and category is something like, for example, you have visited Himalaya. Okay, so for the tagging portion, you have to write only Himalaya, Himalayan birds, Himalayan travelogue, this type of keywords. Himalaya and then the sea also, jungle tour. If you mixed all of these keywords together, then Google will they will not support you, because this is actually a kind of misleading. For example, if a person he types anywhere like Himalayan tourism, and they will find your blog and they will click it, and later on they will be happy that okay, this is a post with Himalayan birds or Himalayan traveler or anything. But if a person is looking for a beach holiday, and you have put it the beach holiday also in your blog post, but there is no text or no image regarding the beach holiday, then Google will penalize you. Because people will visit it, and then when they found nothing, they will just bounce back. So that bouncing will affect your popularity.
Thank you, Anjana.
You need not to, okay.
Another question, very important. How to insert photos in between of paragraphs in a blog post? If you can show us, if you have shown earlier, yes. Please show us. Mm-hmm.
My screen is visible, right?
Yes, very much.
Okay.
Question is specifically in between text.
Just getting some paragraph text anywhere. Okay, now it's a paragraph text, and I have to insert a picture just right beside the where does it come from. Okay, so I have to put the cursor here just beside the where, and then insert image and upload from computer. So your image has come just in between the text, and you can add a caption also.
Can we do it in the middle of the text, like where it is written, where do they come from, and then up below, in between, like the wrapping, as they call it in newspaper.
Yes, actually, this is because of the size of the image. you can need to show you again. When you are selecting the when you are selecting the image, it's just double click, and there is a pencil option. It is a change, I mean the edit option. So you can click the edit option, and the size is medium. You can make it small. Put alt text and title text. Alt text means when the image will not due to some poor net connection, if the image will not show, then the alt text will come, title text, alt text. These are very important, and also for the SEO also. I mean, images cannot be read by Google. You have to put some alt text and title text also for your every image. For example, if you are uploading a birding trip or a travelog trip as a post, and all your text don't have any, I mean, title or any text, alt text or title text, then all will mix up. But if you will put like white-browed bulbul, like red-vented bulbul, all these text you can put in alt text or title text, and then your if your blog is popularized, and if people come to see your blog, and Google will show when someone will write the white-browed bulbul or red-vented bulbul, it may come in the search result. But if you don't put any alt text or title text, it will never.
So alt text will also show when you hover the mouse on the image. Right?
On the image, yes. Okay, now I have make it up. It's a small one, and it's a wrapping option. It's for these are the indent option, paragraph format. All these things are available. And actually this is my image is not that small. If you put a very small image, and you can make it the left indent or right indent.
I will suggest the participants to try it themselves.
There are many options. All the options I have not shown, like, you know, bold, italics, underline. These are the basic option of the Microsoft document. When you are working in Microsoft document, then you can also insert a video also, but that video will you know, take the your drive size. So these options I have not shown you. I have shown you only the basic option, like you can put location, no permalink, yeah, and all these things. Okay, the next question.
Thank you very much, Andrila. We have lots of questions. Let me ask a few more. Okay. Another question is, while registering in blogger.com, do we pay? Do we have to pay there?
No, right? No. Okay. It's only your free Google account. I mean, you just only need to sign in with your free Google account. Google account is free. So no payment is required.
So Vinit is asking, you answered that question partially. When you're uploading a picture, does it affect the sharpness of the image? The quality of the image when you are reducing the size?
No. It will not pixelate it. It will reduce the size.
Pompa is asking, what is the purpose of a gadget? I mean, there are, you showed some gadgets. What is the purpose? You mentioned one.
Okay. Let me show you. I have opened a website. It's well known, Times of India. Okay, these are the gadgets. I mean, this is a advertise option, and here is this is a video option. I think this is the latest news. This is the COVID update. These are different gadgets. They have put, I mean, Times of India is not a blogger website or anything. But when you are asking about gadget is these things. Like, you are putting everything, I mean, about me. You can remove the about me from your blog. If you are trying to make your blog not a personal but an official one, so maybe their about me will not be there. So you can remove about me. About me is actually by default, you will get it. So you can remove it, and you can put anything like available gadgets there. These are the gadgets actually, that for example, this latest videos. So in your blog also, I mean, the blog you are creating in Blogger, there are options like latest post, popular post. You can put those gadgets there. So the latest post and popular post will be shown in that particular place.
Okay. Sharda is asking, can we take images from Google in our blog?
Actually, images taking is not allowed, because that particular person or company can tell you anything. But if you are keen to do, if you don't have any option, you can check the free images that are under Creative Common License, I mean CC license. You can put those images from Google or any free website, full free website or CC images. You can search from Google. So CC images, some URL like Pixabay, they provide Creative Common License. But as soon as you are not making money out of it, they will provide you.
Okay. Another question. Can we embed or upload video and audio clips in my blog?
Yes, yes. Audios are not available, but video is there. I have shown this. After the insert image, there is an insert video option. So you can insert it.
Okay. Thank you. How to get ads in my blog? So I've created a blog. I want to get ads.
Ads, actually, in free option, ad will not be provided. Then you have to do the paid option. I mean, I will show in my own blog that I have put the advertisement. So I will show it later.
Okay, so you are saying that you can, in your paid blog, you can add other advertisement. In the free blog
you
can't
cannot
add advertisement.
No.
But will Blogger put advertisement in my page?
No, I think,
because it is free.
No, yes, Blogger may put. I mean, I have seen in WordPress, I have a WordPress free website also. So WordPress, they will, I mean, you will not be allowed to put your advertisement, but WordPress will put, because it's free, and they will use your, if your blog is popularized, then they will get money out of your blog.
Great. How much does a paid option cost, Blogger? Paid version?
Yes, I will, it's a different slide, and I will show it later.
No problem. Thank you. Anirla, we have done with the questions for this section.
Okay.
You may continue with your presentation.
Okay,
thank you.
Okay. Now, the next option is WordPress.com. Most of you have known the word WordPress, WordPress blog or anything. So, we need to know what is WordPress. WordPress is also a site. This is WordPress.com. WordPress.com, I have already a website there. It's a free website. So it will, when you are registering here, they will ask your email ID and all these things. These are mandatory, like Facebook, like everywhere. You have to put the email ID, the user ID, password, and then your, actually this is my site, free site, WordPress. I will show you making a new one. Here is, actually I have two sites in the same username. Now there is another option, add new site. I will click it. Create a shiny new WordPress.com site. So type the domain you want here. Paste WordPress. Now when you are putting your website, then you are trying to create your WordPress blog in free option, but they will push you with some paid option, like get a 1 year domain registration with any paid plan. In this you can choose any, and you also can create your free WordPress blog also. Okay, I will not click any because I don't need any. You can the person who are asking like the about the cost, they can they can check from here, like hot. I have put it a test WordPress, so hot-test.in, like it is 150 per year. It's only for the domain, I think. And 1260 test.equipment, it's 1260 per year. The domain name, actually it depends, the cost depends upon premium domain, the availability also, and also the how unique it is. If you are trying to register a unique domain, then the cost will be, I mean, much higher. But if you are searching for, like, for my name, Windula Sarkar, if I'm searching windulasarkar.com, I will get it in a cheaper value. But if I'm searching, like, you know, Barding blog or Traveler's Diary or anything, I mean the premium name, so the cost will be much higher, like 14 lakhs. Yesterday I have someone has requested me to let him know about the price of his preferred domain. I have searched, it was a premium domain. He didn't have any idea about premium domain. 500 or 400 domain name was they're selling with 14 lakhs rupees because it is a premium domain. Okay, this is the difference. Okay, now I will show you. I'm not clicking anywhere because of the, this is my, okay, when you will click with your free plan, then they will redirect to your website. I mean, it is made before, but it will be full, like the blogger I have just let you know. The blogger, the same thing happens with the WordPress also. Okay, this is the design, and you can customize this design. There are some themes available, you can choose any theme. Another important thing is when you are customizing these options, even this is true for Wix also, all you can find in the left panel. Same thing happens with Blogger, with WordPress, with Wix. There are nothing, anything anywhere, only the left panel. You can check the site identity, like my name was painting and photo. I have made the logo and uploaded it here. You can change your logo, site title, everything. Site icon means when you are clicking a tab. A tab is displayed in your website, in your browser. You can check a tiny image just beside the name of your URL. This is called fav icon or set site icon. You can change it also. Okay. So everything is customizable. Okay. This is the customize option. There are menus, header image, create new menu, menu name. Menu means the navigation, like I have put home, about, painting, photography, travel stories, all these things. If you like to create, if you like to click and make your own, you can play around with these options, like in WordPress or in Blogger, you can play around. There are many options. In the time constraints, I may not be able to show you everything, but this is also in WordPress, actually. The gadget, they are called widget. This is same thing, but different name. Widget means the search option. So this is the search option. Okay, you can remove it, but I will not suggest anyone to remove the search panel from your website or your blog, because from there people can search, or you also can search, because you may not be able to memorize the URL every time. Instagram and follow blog categories, all these things are available here. I mean, my footer option. This is a search option. This is the follow in Instagram option. These all are widgets. In Blogger, we were calling it gadget and categories, and in these are some images. Gallery. Gallery in a monochromatic world, like I put it like that. So this is my site. Actually, I have made it before. You can check. You can make it. I have made it before, and this is actually free. So you can make it yourself. Let me click any in any blog post. Okay, bird ringing. There are paragraphs and photos in between, and you can put the title text also. I didn't put it, and I have actually linked with the eBard also here. And if you are sending it to your friends, your acquaintances, they can see everything and can comment, like the Facebook or YouTube. So this is also, people used to get liked it, and they will, like, you know, this is a nice option to put everything in. Okay. You can share from here also. In WordPress, in Twitter, in Facebook, and 8 bloggers like this. When you are creating a blog in WordPress.com, there is actually, it's a kind of community. So other WordPress bloggers, 8 WordPress bloggers, they liked it. And there are some related posts, like it's a birding post, and so the Namiri Tiger Reserve and West Sikkim bird watching and Mangalajuri bird watching, these options are coming here automatically, because I have put the tagline somewhere in birding only. So the same type of posts are fetching themselves here. This is the advertisement option. Okay. So as your blog is free, so you are not able to put any AdSense or any, I mean, advertisement anywhere. But WordPress can put their advertisement here. So if you are, if you want to remove this advertisement, so you have to upgrade it. Upgradation means the money, and then you have to give the money according to their plan, and they will let you know the, about the plans and how much. If you are choosing a premium domain, then how much it will cost you and everything. Now I think I can take questions on WordPress, and after that I will continue with the Wix and other slides. Thank you.
Thank you. Guys, please post your questions in the chat. In the meanwhile, one question is there from Purnendu. I think WordPress has got more options than Blogspot. What is your view?
Yes, yes. Definitely WordPress has more options.
I don't see any questions coming in. Looks like you have made it very clear and easy to understand. What should be the length of an ideal blog? Karuna Shri is asking that, or we're getting many questions.
Yes, ideal size, I will discuss it later. I have a separate slide also. Just keep in mind to ask it again.
Okay, fine. Okay. Among the three sides, which is more user friendly?
More user friendly, I think WordPress and the blog both are user friendly. Actually, Blogger is more like, you know, it's simple. But WordPress needs, I will suggest, if you are not technical enough, and blogging and what website, you haven't made any website before, I will suggest you to make a blog or website in Blogger. Then afterwards, gradually you can learn the WordPress also, because WordPress is like, you know, standard two, and standard one is Blogger. It's very simple and very user friendly. And then WordPress, and then Wix is a bit difficult.
Okay, Vinit is asking, is WordPress account only eligible for 1 year free?
No. Free is actually for lifetime. But this, my website is also, it's 3-4 years back I have made it. So it's free, and no one will charge you. But if you are, you can check my URL. It's paintingandphoto.wordpress.com. If I have to put paintingandphoto.com, then I have to buy the URL from WordPress.
Got it. Thank you. How much money one can earn from a blog?
I will discuss it later.
Okay, I will keep that question for later.
Not for the, I mean, no money can be earned from the free sites. Because free sites are actually, they have some regulations that you may not be able to put the advertisement. The main money comes from the advertisement only. So you have to...
Okay. Adil is asking, why did you choose WordPress over Blogger? I think you mentioned earlier, but you can repeat. Mm-hmm.
WordPress is good. I mean, the second option. But WordPress, actually the themes available in WordPress, they are more user friendly, they are more beautiful looking. For example, the site I have made in WordPress, and which is actually completely free, you cannot make it in Blogger. The look and feel, you will not get this feel in Blogger. Blogger is very simple, very I mean, it's like one-dimensional. So if you will use it, you can understand.
Thank you. Another question from Karuna Shri. How often should be the post on our blogs so that the WordPress account is kept alive.
No, it's alive for the lifetime. There will not be this is my free blog, and I am not using it till last 1.5 years, because I have moved all my things for new website. But it is there. I mean, okay. I have opened it after a long time.
Okay, thank you. Is there any technical tool for non-technical person for the smooth running and updating for this blog?
You have to create your blog in from computer. Setup required because computer need a more computer have. There are many options like customizing themes and. But when updating it, you can do it from the application, mobile application, and there is a very simple application, and there is the like plus sign. You have to click the plus sign, and you can write from your mobile. And from mobile, you may not be able to upload the photos like the eBird, but you can write down the text, and afterwards you can upload the photos from your computer.
Okay, fine. Another question about frequency. Is there any fixed frequency to upload, update a blog, or there is up to your choice?
No, basically it's up to your choice. But the more you will update, the more Google will crawl you, and the more it will be popularized.
Okay, got it. There is another question about money. I will ask you later on when you talk about money. So I'll keep that question for pending. Everybody is saying thank you to the questions you have answered. Thank you very much. You may move to the next section. We have how many minutes left? We have 4 minutes left, and then we can we have to disconnect and connect again. You can start.
Okay. The next option is wix.com, wix.com. Then you have to make your website. Your email, I have just confirmed my email. Okay, now Wix, you have to click on the create new site. It's a blue big button. What kind of website do you want to create? Is business designer, and here is the option blog. Okay. Click blog, create your website with a Wix editor. Choose a template. There are many templates. Wix templates are very good to look at. I mean, you can choose any one. Like I'm choosing this one. There's a edit and view option. I am not viewing it because I know this is already. Now here you can easily drag and drop everything. Like salt and pepper is your site name. You can change it like taste. You can put it anywhere. And this Wix is like drag and drop, and you can drag it anywhere, like here or here, anywhere. Okay. These options are social media bar. These options are also scalable and removable. All these things you can play around. Like it's a it automatically taking a food blog. You can change the theme, the heading, like food blog. You can make the font size bigger. You can change the photos also. Actually, if you are using Wix, I think it will be easier for the non-technical person to, I mean, navigate very easily because it's already created. But you may not, I mean, I will always recommend Google first because Google is Google. Wix may not be, I mean, Wix is a very popular site, but nothing can beat Google. That's why I always recommend Google. Yeah, but still, if you are looking for a less, if you are looking for a non-technical option, then you can choose Wix also because Wix is, you can check the, already the site template is ready. You need not to create anything. You need not to, I mean, you just have to change the image and the text only and your Wix website or blog, whatever, it will be created. And now you can publish it. And another thing is, like, you know, my name was, user account was Wild India Travels. So the name, freewix.com site will be like https wildindiatravels.wixsite.com/mysite. It's a longer one. No one will type it. But if you save the typing time, then you have to go for the paid option, which is which will redirect you to the their paid plan. So, like, I'm just taking it test. Save and continue. Publish your site so people can see it. So I'm publishing it. View site. So you can check within a few click. My new site is ready for you to check. I think you can make your site within today if you really want. I mean, it's ready. wildindiatravels.wixsite.com/test. Now I think I can take questions about wix.com. Thank you.
Sure. I'll ask one question. Bala is asking, my photos are on Flickr, and if my videos are on YouTube, how do I integrate them into Wix blog?
If there is any option, I don't know. I have to check whether there is any option because, you know, YouTube is easily can link with the blogger because both are from Google. But if you, I don't know, I have to check whether Wix, you can take the photos from Wix. Because when I'm just clicking this one, manage post. I was trying to edit an existing post. Edit. I have selected the photos and I will try to change it. I'm just trying to change the size of it. Click this image. Uh, no, there is no any option to connect with the Flickr. I mean, you only can upload media or media from Wix. From Wix free library, you can choose your photos from Shutterstock and from Unsplash. These are all basically tied up company. Like Wix is they're using their own library, and Shutterstock or Unsplash, they are tied up company. So they are promoting like this. So Flickr is not added here. You cannot add the Flickr photos directly, but obviously you can download from Flickr.
Okay, what about YouTube?
Hello?
How about YouTube? The same instead of
this is only for the you can upload the media. It's Google Drive, you can check from okay. You can check the yes, here is the Flickr option also
So what you are showing is if you have photos on Flickr or Google Drive, you can connect
yes,
them.
Yes, there is an option. Sorry, previously I have missed it. There is an option. You can check. I mean, any option like Wix account or Google Drive or Facebook or Instagram, Dropbox, Google Photos, Flickr, DeviantArt, and Dribbble also. So you can. You can check, you can connect any account
okay.
And add your media.
Thank you for that. That is answered. Is the website designed in Wix more web mobile friendly in terms of viewing
yes.
or editing?
All are mobile friendly. I mean, all are actually responsive. You can choose from WordPress or Wix or anywhere. All are mobile friendly. There will not be
in terms of editing as well as also viewing for others, which
same
is better.
From others.
All are same, right?
All are same. There are you know you can check. I mean some almost same, but you may not get all the points in particular website, but they are almost all are same.
Okay, you showed an option called as apps in Wix. What is that apps option?
Apps option, I mean, no, I have told you that from mobile, you also can get all the options. I mean, all the applications and you can download those from. But when you are setting up a website like this one that I have set up a complete website, then it's okay. I mean, I can use
in a previous screen there was when you were in the blog I think here only in Wix there was an apps option. That's what the question is.
Add apps.
Something was there.
These are the apps like you know it's shipping app like Shippo. It's like free. The same option you can get in WordPress. Those are called plugins. Same thing actually when you are changing the platform from Wix to WordPress to anything, then the names, the identities are changing. When you are trying to installing anything like Printful, Shippo or anything, these are apps in Wix, but same thing is called plugin in WordPress. So if you are delivering anything, you need shipping, you can use it. All these things are like MailChimp is newsletter. These are the advanced option actually. When you are making it, you can gradually move forward.
Thank you. No more questions on Wix, Anila. You can move ahead with the presentation.
Okay. My okay. Now your blog is made, which you have seen already. That I have. It only takes a few minutes to make my own blog, but it's not a very happy thing. Like you know, you have made your blog, but actually it's like a baby, and you have to nurture it. and you have to put you have to invest time on it, because you have to popularize it. It's not it will not work anything itself. You have to work for it and you have to give time. Now I will let you know about the free web hosting and paid comparison. That free web hosting service include their name in your site, unique domain name. Like you have seen that wildindiatravels.com/weeks.com/your site name. Okay, or like if I want to use my name, like windrilla sharkar/blogspot.com or windrilla sharkar/wordpress.com. So free web hosting will always include their company name with your domain name. I think it's clear. And speed is one of the top factor. The free sites are not that speedy. You can check yourself. But when you are taking a paid hosting, they will give you more speed. And speed is necessary for the user also, because when you are viewing a website, you will not, people are actually impatient. They will not try and look. I mean, time is very important for people, because if a person come to your site and they can show that they will, experience that your site is taking too much time to load, they will bounce back, and the bouncing rate will show in the Google, and Google will, they will penalize you. Your site will not get good result. The next option is your free hosted website comes with the baggage of advertisement, which I have told that you cannot put any AdSense account or anything advertisement. You cannot make money out of it. You only can showcase your photos, your travelog to someone, but you cannot make money, because WordPress or Wix, or they are actually they will actually make money, but not you. The next thing is for customer support. In free hosting, you will only get the, you will be redirected to the FAQ page. Frequently answered question. There's a question answer already defined by the websites. So you will get redirected to that page, and there are no customer executive available to answer you, because you are taking free service. And high uptime will be very high, and unlimited email account with free domain name you will not get with free domain name. As you have seen, there are no free domain name, free email account. But if you are using a paid option, then free names are, name will be provided. And also thing is security. When you are taking the free web hosting, may not be secured, but actually I haven't found anything unsecure till now. But because Google is also Google, actually Google or WordPress, they are big companies, so their security is unquestionable. But still, security is the option. I mean, they will also, I mean, big companies also provide security first. They will prioritize the paid users first, and then it will come, because you are using a free account. Another thing is how to popularize your blog. So you can, if you want to popularize, and if you don't want to popularize, only just write the text and upload the media and share it with your friend. And this is the way you can popularize. And other than that, if you want to popularize it, if you are taking the paid options, and you want to make money out of your blog, and you want to add the AdSense. Also, I want to show you my paid site. I have moved to a free site to a paid one. This is my website or blog, whatever. And you can check, here is a advertisement option. So if this is PPC app, I mean, if anyone click here I will get the payment, and this is a very small amount. Like I haven't got paid till now because it's a birding block, and birds and environment, these are the less popularized subjects. But if you really want to make a popular blog, you can choose any other subject apart from birds or apart from anything. Tourism is fine. Tourism, if you want to write to travel blog, then it's okay. But birding is not a very popular subject. Otherwise, you can go for food blog and politics and entertainment. These are very popular, tend to be popular. I mean, people used to click on the entertainment pages and pop politics type of news type of portals. So you can go for this. So this is the ad option. As I have not used any, I'm not using my free website again anymore. That's why I have put the blog here. I have put the advertisement here, and now the simple popularization method is content. Someone have asked that what should be the size of the blog or size of the text. You can write it as much as possible. I mean, it could be texty, it could be word heavy, because words can be read by the Google. So if you want my content tips, I will tell you that yes, make it text heavy, so that Google will crawl you, but not boring things. I mean, people should attract. I mean, it's like a book. It should be unputdownable. Like when we are talking about a book, it should be unputdownable. I mean, when you are reading a book, you may not, the user may not, stop reading there. They should move forward. They should glued to your website, to your post. So my content tips will be, yes, make it content heavy, make it text heavy. But make it relevant, actually. Don't put gibberish text, and don't put unnecessary text anywhere. Okay. So next is use of SEO tool. I will show you the SEO tools from my website. This is my dashboard, and this is the SEO. This is, I have made it in WordPress. Okay. When I am writing a post, for example, this is my latest post. I will edit it. It's a post of tiger trip and bird watching trip. There is a difference. So I have just wanted to put my experiences in a funny method. So these are my illustrations. I have put it to make it funnier, to make it more shareable. Some content is have a shareable portion. So my other posts are not shareable, but this is a different thing. I have wanted to try it. You can check with every image. I have put a text. It's a alternative text, and okay. It's a SEO tool. I have it's a SEO plugin, actually, in WordPress. This is called plugin. You can install it from the side menu. Here you can see a plugin option. Go to add new and install the SEO plugin. I have installed it, Yoast SEO. This is the most popular. This actually comes in the first option. So Yoast, you can also write down the name, Yoast, Yoast SEO. It is when you are clicking the Yoast SEO, see, there are no readability issue or any focus preface. My focus preface is tiger tree. So when people used to write anywhere in tiger tree, so maybe my blog will come. That's why it is my focus preface. I have put it. And there are also some analytic results. There are also some problems. Like my text has key phrase in meta description. Like I haven't put the meta description. These all are SEO things. When you are creating a blog, it is the part one, and part two is popularization. Okay. So key phrase in Slug. It's like, you know, Slug means when you are searching anything in Google, like I'm searching the taste. This is the thing. I mean, this is the site title. This is the URL. And this is the Slug. I have put everything in order. That's why it is showing that Slug is okay. Title, key phrase in title. I mean, my title is Tiger Trip versus Bird Watching Trip. And my focus preface is also Tiger Trip. So my key phrase is actually, it is present in the title. Text length, my text length is good. It's 775 words. So it's good word count. So these are the things you have to, it is very easy. All you need to understand that they will redirect, they will let you know how to improve. Like improvement, I have, you can see that image alt attributes. I haven't put all images in alt keyframe, in alt text. That's why out of 9 images on this page, only one has alt attribute. But I have to put all the attributes here. So you can check it yourself and you can make a good blog. I mean, they will suggest you. All these plugins have options to suggest you what is best for you. Now, the second thing is designing. So make your blog a very good design. It should be very simple, very user friendly. Don't make it. I mean, navigation should be in the top or in the left side. Don't make it different from the usual blogs. Make it user friendly so that people can navigate through your website. And the fourth point is utility. Utility means the importance, like which I have told you about that, you know, birding and environment, these sort of things, people will not get interest very easily. Otherwise, you are a birder or a environmentalist or anything. But these are the, you know, backbencher subjects. You can make your first blog with anything else. But if you are keen to do, I mean, you have to, like I, if I want to make a blog with politics, since I don't have any interest in politics, I cannot make a political blog. I can write one or two posts, but for what will be after the second or third? Because after the third option, I may not be able to write anything. I have to choose the subject in which I am very frequent, in which I have the potentiality to produce new content. So that is also very important. So, and utility means people want to get the tips and people want to get the informative blogs and informative videos. So this is also very important. And social media sharing is important. You can share your blog in other social media, in Facebook, in Instagram, in YouTube. So that people will redirect to your website or your blog and they will get the information. Now you can make it like, you know, I don't know, the whole how the whole session is like, you know, is it very informative? Some of you have also told that no, it's too much information. I mean, I will tell you that no, it's not too much information. There are many options that you have. If you can, you know, click anywhere, it will not take your money. when the paid option and free option will come, then only you have to, I mean, click very carefully that whether you will not, you know, redirected to your any paid option or anything. But otherwise, it's easy. I mean, don't think that it is very, I am technical. That's why I have told so much things. These are very information heavy, but it's not like that. These are very simple. So I would like to conclude here and keep calm and make your blog, and don't forget to let me know. Most of you have known me personally, so don't forget to let me know if you have already created your blog or already started, I don't know. Thank you, Francis sir, thank you for this session, and if there is any question, I can answer.
Sure, thank you, Anila, for the session. There are lots of questions. I will start one by one. Okay. Can switching between Wix and Blogger possible?
No, both are different platforms. No, both are different platforms. I mean, if you want to create, then you have to make the whole thing newly in a different platform.
Okay, understood. Okay. So migration is not possible. What is the average cost to maintain a blog, a paid domain? Blog with paid domain.
Paid domain actually depends, because I have told you about the you have to check from GoDaddy, from WordPress, all are different. They have domain and all these things are differently put the price. So I mean, if you are taking the test.com, for example, test.com actually a premium domain, it is not available maybe. But if you are looking for test.com, the domain name is differently priced in WordPress and differently in other, I mean, in Wix or anything. So you have to check their plans.
Okay. How to check if I am writing correct English? Is there any tool? Adil has answered
yes.
Grammarly as one example.
Grammarly. I use Grammarly, yeah.
Okay, great. Thank you. How can I check if someone is copying my blog?
Copyscape.com.
Copy?
You can Copyscape, Copyscape.
Okay.
Copyscape.com. If your content is 100% original, and you will get the result. Because, for example, in my blog, I have put my birding experiences in Shatal, in Nasik. And if you will write Nasik bird watching trip, my blog will come to the first. I haven't paid any penny for that. But it comes forward because all my content is original. But if you are making the original content, your blog will definitely score high.
Thank you. You showed the Yoast SEO option. Is that a paid version?
No. Yes, all the options are free, and there are options with paid also. I mean, Yoast is also free and paid also.
Okay.
If you want to upgrade, you can.
Okay. Question again coming up on the user friendly. Which one you think is user friendly among the three?
User friendly. I think Wix is more user friendly, but Wix is a bit difficult because the overall thing is difficult. But Blogger is like, you know, scribbling like a child. When I am using Blogger, because there are no options. You cannot be mess up with anything. Because there are no options to mess up.
Okay. Is Grammarly, you mentioned Grammarly, is it a website or an app, or what is it?
Both. You can do with website, or there are app also. They will put a keyboard. Actually, you can install a Grammarly keyboard also in your mobile.
Okay. So coming back to the money part here, somebody is asking, can I connect my YouTube video channel with WordPress to earn money?
Yes, you can.
You can, okay.
You can. Because it's like, you know, your YouTube videos will be published in your WordPress blog, which is actually free. and other blogger will show, will view your website, and they may click to the YouTube channel, and they can and you can get the views and viewers and subscribers as well.
Okay, fine. Someone is asking, I have a website, I have a blog, I have a FB page. Can I amalgamate all three into one account?
All.
Let me complete. If I update my blog regularly and attach with FB page, then the FB page will automatically update, and vice versa?
Automatically update means, yes. When you are, writing a blog post, there are options that share to your any social media, Facebook or whatever, Instagram and all. So you can choose that option. But yes, you have to click the share option. No one will click on behalf of you, but you have to click, and then you will get the audience from there.
Okay, fine. Thank you. Is there any option to take backup before I mess up everything? Supratim is asking this question.
No, basically backup, like you have to make the backup to yourself. There are no options for the free option, the free domain. But if you are taking the paid option, then you can backup everything. If you are going for the free hosting, no backup is available.
Okay, fine. Thank you. You are getting lots of thanks and good wishes on the chat. Those will disappear once we close the meeting. And I have no more questions. Anjula, you have been great help and great presentation. Thank you for sharing your experience and your knowledge with us. I'm saying this on behalf of all the participants. And to the participants, thank you very much for joining and staying with us for the last three different parts. As you know, this is a free app which we are using, and obviously we have to disconnect and connect to keep it going. So if it was a paid app, Zoom, then we would have continued for longer in one session. I hope you were not inconvenienced with this, but if we have caused you inconvenience, we apologize for that. Thank you for joining. Anjula, if you want to say anything last.
Thank you everyone for joining, and hope you have learned. If there is any option, you can create your blog and let me know. Thank you and namaste to everyone.
Great, thank you.
Stay safe.
Yeah, you're also getting lots of thanks on the chat, you can see. Finally, last word, I will be uploading the recording of the entire session by evening on YouTube, and I will share it on the WhatsApp group. The link, we will be able to recap if you need to, or share it with other people. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much. You may leave the meeting now. We are closing it.
Thank you very much.